Hello everyone, I'm F. Teddy Samson of Class 12A. I wish you all a very happy Vijayadashami. In this auspicious event, I will be sharing a few information about Vijayadashami. In this video, we'll be knowing about who is Ma Durga, the story of Ma Durga, and how people celebrate the festival all over India. So let's begin. As I told you, who is Ma Durga? Well, this can be viewed in two perspectives. First, the mythological perspective. She is a supreme goddess who had incarnated to kill the demon Mahishasura. Second, practical perspective. She is the symbol of women empowerment. She is the very epitome of Nari Shakti, namely women power. She is the protector of women from their exploitation and harassment. Now, as you have come to know about Ma Durga, let us get to know her story as well. There was a cunning and evil demon named Mahishasura. He wanted to become the ruler of the Triloka, the heaven, hell, and the earth. He didn't have the sufficient power to become one. So he did a devoted, dedicated, and undistracted penance to Lord Brahma. After several years, Lord Brahma was pleased and appeared in front of the demon to grant him a boon. First, Mahishasura asked that he wanted to become eternal and immortal, but as that was not possible, he wished that only a woman would be the cause of his death. He thought that women were the weakest of all. Lord Brahma happily granted the boon and disappeared. Now that Mahishasura had received the boon, he went to the Devlok, the abode of the Devas, and defeated Lord Indra, the king of gods. Now the Devas were left as prey. They were helpless, weak, and vulnerable. They had no choice other than asking help from the Trimurti, namely Brahma, the creator, Vishnu, the peacemaker, and Shiva, the destroyer. The Trimurtis knew that the reign of Mahishasura would bring no good to the universe but only destruction. So they united at one place and a bright light emerged out of their bodies and joined at one point. There appeared a beautiful maiden. They named her Durga. Durga has other names as well. Eight major names are: she was called Jagdamba, mother of the entire universe. She is called Sarva Chakra Dharini, the one who possesses a massive chakra in her hand, which was gifted by Lord Vishnu. She was called Tejaswarupini, since she emerged from the celestial lights of the Trimurtis. She is also called Jyotiswarupa. She was as bright as the flames of a lamp or diya. The gods called her Devi Padma Lochani, as her eyes were like the beautiful petals of the lotus flower. The gods called her Vindhyavasini, as she was offered an abode from the Devas, which was called Vindhya, a mountain. She is also called Sinhavahini, as she was offered a lion as vehicle. She is also called Devi Mahatmyam, the goddess of great soul and high supremacy. Now that the goddess had emerged, she was offered an abode and a vehicle, and she was adorned with jewels and weapons. She was well prepared for the battle. She bid the Devas and departed to face the demon. She challenged the demon and battled with him. The battle occurred for 10 days. Mahishasura suffered great loss, but still he was not ready to accept his defeat in the hands of a woman. But finally, on the 10th day, the sharp Trishul of the goddess struck the evil, cunning, and boastful heart of the demon. The demon was shattered and faced his death. This day is called Vijayadashami. Vijay means victory, and Dashami means the 10th day. And here we come to the end of this story. Now let's see how the celebrations of Vijayadashami and Navratri take place all over India. In most of the parts of South India, the three Devis are worshipped during the time of Navratri. 3 days are delegated for each goddess. The first 3 days, Devi Parvati is worshipped for courage and valor. The next 3 days, Devi Lakshmi is worshipped for wealth and prosperity. The last 3 days, Devi Saraswati is worshipped for wisdom and knowledge. We also decorate our houses by the help of Golu dolls, and for the improvement of our good deeds and karma, we also do rice donations called Annadanam. In some other parts of India, Vijayadashmi is also celebrated as Dashera, the victory of Lord Ram over the ten-headed demon Lankadipati Ravan. In most of the North India and Western India, Navratri is celebrated by worshipping Ganav Durga, nine forms of the goddess. The first form, Devi Shailputri. After the demise of Dakshayini or Sati, the goddess was reborn as Parvati to the Himalayan king and queen Himavan and Manavati. The second form, Devi Brahmacharini, the goddess who did a dedicated penance to become the consort of Lord Shiva. The third form, Devi Chandraganta, the newly married goddess who defeated demons with sheer faith and belief with the help of Ghanta, temple bells. The fourth form, Devi Kushmanda, the motherly goddess who caters the entire universe in the sun as her abode. The fifth form, Devi Skandmata, the goddess who gave birth to Dev Skand or Kartikeya. The sixth form, Devi Katyayini, the daughter form of goddess to defeat Mahishasur. The seventh form, Devi Kalratri, the one with the dreadful appearance who vanquishes all the evildoers. The eighth form, Devi Mahagauri, the goddess who brings peace and harmony among all the beings of the nature. And the last form, the ninth form, Devi Siddhidatri, the provider of wisdom and to all her devotees. During the Navdurga worship, the Navdurga Kavach is recited. Pratamam Shailaputri cha Dvitiyam Brahmacharini Tritiyam Chandra Ghanteti Kushmandeti Chaturthakam Panchamam Skandamateti Shashtamam Katyayini cha Saptamam Kalaratriti Mahagauri cha Ashtamam Navamam Siddhidatri te Navadurga Pratirtitaha. Thank you everyone for your patience listening. I would like to conclude my presentation by reciting the Devi Sloka. Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shakti Rupena Sanskrita Namastase Namastase, Namastase Namo Namaha. May Goddess Durga guide, guard and protect you all the days of your life. Jai Ma Durga.